This video provides a brief introduction to the Mastering Chemistry Organic Structure Drawing Tool. To draw the structure for C3H6, we begin by clicking on the Bond tool. If we go over to the canvas and drag, we see that two carbon atoms are drawn out. If we then click on one of the carbon atoms and drag again, we create another carbon atom on the end. Hydrogen atoms may be added by selecting H from the right-hand palette, then clicking on a carbon and dragging outward. Each time we do this, we add a hydrogen atom and the associated bond. At this point, we have three carbon atoms and eight hydrogens. However, the formula was C3H6. This means that one of the bonds between two carbon atoms must be a double bond, since carbon always makes four bonds. To create a double bond, click on the bonding tool once again, then click on a bond between two carbon atoms. Notice the formation of the double bond. Since two of the carbon atoms are now showing five bonds, we need to get rid of a hydrogen atom on each carbon. To do this, we select the eraser tool and click on each of the extra hydrogen atoms. At this point, we should have the correct structure. Since each of the carbon atoms has four bonds and each of the hydrogens has one, if we submit our answer, we see that it is correct. In the next example, we are asked to write the generic structure of an ether. Ethers have a general formula of ROR, where R stands for a hydrocarbon or alkyl group. Now, according to the instructions in this particular problem, we are to use CH3 for the hydrocarbon group. In other words, instead of writing R, we use CH3. We place the oxygen atom out on the grid first. Unless otherwise specified, hydrogen atoms are always implied in condensed structures. Next, we select a carbon atom and drag out from each side of the oxygen atom. Once the structure is complete, we click on Submit, and we see we have the correct answer. The next molecule is 3-ethyl-2-methylhexane. The parent chain in this case has six carbon atoms. To draw out a chain of six carbons, we click on the tool that kind of looks like a zigzag, and we drag out. Notice as we do that the number count increases, and we stop when we get up to a total of six. This represents a six-carbon parent chain. Next, we need to add a methyl group to the second carbon in the chain, so we click on the single bond tool, and we drag out from the second carbon. The tool that looks like a zigzag gives us multiple carbons, and since we want an ethyl group off the number 3 carbon, we click on that zigzag shape tool and we drag out and add two additional carbons to the number 3 carbon in the chain. Before submitting, we check to see that our answer is correct. We see that we have 6 carbon atoms in the parent chain. We have a 1 carbon branch off the second carbon in the chain and a 2 carbon branch off the third carbon in the chain. Should we have a preference for showing all the hydrogen atoms, the H plus or minus key toggles back and forth between showing the hydrogens and turning them off. We click on Submit, and we see we have the correct answer. To draw the structure for propane, we need 3 carbon atoms. One of the bonds between the two atoms needs to be a triple bond. The triple bond is selected from the palette on the left-hand side by clicking on the triangle in the lower right-hand corner of the bond icon. Going back to the molecule, we click on the position where we want the bond to be located. Once again, we submit our answer, and we see that it is correct. To draw the structure of 3-pentanol, we write out a parent chain that has 5 carbon atoms. To add an oxygen atom, we select O from the right-hand palette. We drag out from the number 3 carbon, and this gives us 3-pentanol. To draw a molecule of octanoic acid, we need an 8-carbon parent chain. Since octanoic acid is classified as a carboxylic acid, we convert one of the terminal carbons to a carboxyl group by adding in two oxygen atoms. One of those oxygen atoms should have a double bond, the other an OH. Once the molecule is complete, we click on the submit button. Wait a minute, something's wrong with this one. What did we do wrong? If we count the carbon atoms, we see we actually have a total of 9 carbons. Remember that each corner represents a carbon. To correct this, we select the eraser tool and remove the entire carboxyl group, including both oxygen atoms. Now, with 8 carbon atoms, we've replaced the carboxyl group. We submit our answer, and we see that it is correct.